Bumper to bumper, tensions flare as drivers wait to merge into the Massey Tunnel.
It's very frustrating, especially with children in the car.
Another tunnel would be great.
This is the main source of frustration behind me here, where three lanes of traffic are funneling into one.
I gotta go home. I'm not gonna be home for dinner, you know?
Drivers like Chris Nicholson have had enough.
I leave work at 3:30. To get home at 7 and from 3:30, it's ridiculous.
But changes could soon be on the way. This week, a Metro Vancouver committee recommended the province replace this tunnel with one that's twice the size.
More or less with the same design, but obviously with more capacity.
UBC engineer Eric Eberhardt says it's a cost-effective and familiar option.
It follows a sort of a proven design. So the existing Massey Tunnel, being an immersed tunnel, they have 60 years of experience in terms of how that tunnel has performed.
We would respect the salmon that we are so proud of. And this project is putting all of that at risk for an unknown price tag.
The tunnel was not our preferred option.
The Tawasin First Nation has also raised concerns about the marine environment. Chief Ken Baird voted against the project in favor of a bridge.
Starting a river project of this magnitude, in my mind, can only make things worse for the salmon runs and the spawning beds for the sturgeon.
But the First Nation says it's not going to fight the project, and the NDP's Green Party partners don't buy the environmental argument.
This will be a small, short-term effect that can be minimized, and in the long term, there'll likely be no effect on the salmon because it's really just another rock on the bottom of the seafloor, a slightly bigger one, and ecosystems adapt relatively rapidly.
The province will now move to draft up an environmental assessment and figure out just how much the new tunnel will cost. If things stay on track, officials say it could be complete as soon as 2025. John Hernandez, CBC News, Vancouver.